All right, moving forward, we have our keynote speaker who would be speaking to the new age consumer. In the past, he served as the managing director of Tata Motors Limited and as the director of consumer electronics at Philips India and director of marketing at LML Limited. He's currently the man behind Fast Track, for which I was a social media influencer as well. Please welcome on stage Chief Executive Officer, Watches and Accessories, and EVP Corporate Communications Titan, Mr. Ravi Kant. Come on, ladies and gentlemen. Hello, sir. Looking forward.
Thanks, Siddharth, for the introduction. The only thing that I like to state is that you introduced another Ravi Kant and not me, who happened to be my colleague in Titan many, many years back. I'm actually delighted to be here today, you know, in the midst of bright minds that I can sense and feel. I'd like to thank Anurag and Exchange for Media for giving me this opportunity. We've heard two amazing speakers so far, and I'd like to thank them for setting up the context. When I was told that I'm supposed to speak on connecting with the new age consumer, and I was told that I should try and share some stories from Titan, some case study from there. So I said, I'll do that. So thanks once again to the speakers who've spoken earlier on and set up the context. So I'll move on. You know, we've heard some very interesting examples of brands around the world, how they're using digital marketing. But let me bring you back to India and see what we're doing here. And let me start with a story. This is the story of a train. On the 10th of December 2015, a train from Varanasi to New Delhi was on its way. The pantry of that train ran out of milk, and it caused great discomfort to a young infant and her mother, of course. The frustrated mother tweeted at 11:03 a.m. And guess what happened? The Ministry of a Railway swung into action. They asked the divisional railway manager of Allahabad to do something about it. And at 11:47 a.m., at Fatehpur station, when the train stopped, the station master brought milk to that infant. And see, this is what is happening in India, and I'm talking of 2015. So this is an amazing story of how an ecosystem of support was mobilized using different facets of digital. You know, over the last couple of years, or if you say last 5-6 years, developments like social, developments like search, where, you know, information on the web has actually been democratized by Google, life around us has changed. We are connecting with consumers in a very different way. And finally, who's a new age consumer? New age consumers are not just millennials, are not just young people. All of us are new age consumers irrespective of age. Just look at this data point. It took us 2 decades to reach 200 million internet users. And in the next 5 years, we've added another 250 million and counting. So what led to this revolution? Mobile phone prices dropped by 50% in just about 4 years, which led to penetration of mobile phones going up to 30% from 3% in just that 5 year period. Mobile phone internet boom you know, just in 7 months with the geo revolution that we all went through and experienced, there were 100 million consumers added. And of course, aided by speed of internet, which rose 5 times in that 4 or 5 year period. When we talk of new age consumer, as I was saying earlier, the standard stereotype that comes to mind are young people and urban people, but that's not true. Take a look at this data from BCG. I think the slides are moving. One sec, let me just come back. I don't know if it's a battery issue with the remote. I was talking about consumers who are not just young. You know, the new age consumer is not just young and urban, but if you look at this data from the BCG report, we have 54% consumers who are more than 25 years, greater than 25 years, and that used to be about 40% 4 or 5 years back. If you look at consumers from the non-metro and the smaller towns, the tier two towns, we have 50% from this segment, and this used to be 29%, I think about 4 years back. So the digital consumer and the new age consumer is not just he's not just young and not just an urban consumer, but all over the place. And that is how we need. That's something that we need to recognize, to be able to reach out to them. Take a look at this data from again the BCG report that I was talking about. With maturity, as you start using and get used to the internet, the amount of media you consume online goes on increasing from 30% to 42%. So if you take the first two blocks, which is less than 3 years of being online, you go from 30 to 34. And then finally, if you have been in the space for more than 3 years, it goes up to 42%. But what I interestingly want to talk about are the archetypes, because each of these, the consumer archetypes, each of these are not the same. Within each block. So if you take the first block, there are three archetypes that I'd like to talk about. The late learners, the data discoverers, and the novel networkers. And then we'll move on to consumers in the space of people who've been using it for greater than 3 years, which are really the digital enthusiasts or entertainment enthusiasts, active aspirers, and the social shoppers. So let's take a look at the first one. The data discoverers are people from small towns, semi-urban areas who are discovering internet for the first time, have just acquired their mobile phone, and then discovering this whole pleasure. So this is one set of type of consumers. Then you have the late learners, and these are generally older people who are being attracted to this whole space by young in the family. It could be your children, it could be sometimes even your grandson who's pushing you to start using the internet and the mobile phone, and they're most active on Facebook as well as looking at news online. And then the novel networkers, which are also from tier 2 and 3 towns, they're new to the internet world, mostly women, and therefore not very comfortable of shopping online. Moving on to the second block, which I said are people who've been using this for the last for more than 3 years, are people who are active aspirers. These are young consumers, young people. For them, being online is in a sense a lifestyle. Everything that they do is online. If you move on to the entertainment enthusiasts, these are the most active, and spend most time because they're into gaming, they're into entertainment, their music all the time. And then finally, social shoppers, which are also women. Who are very comfortable shopping online, and for them it's the best way to spend time. Now moving on to, now that was very briefly setting the context, and like I said, there is lots happening in India itself, and we have in Titan a portfolio of brands, Titan, Sonata, Fast Track, Xylus, all of that, and we've tried to use in each of our brands, these pens of Our marketing spends are ranging from a minimum of, I would say, 15% in digital to growing to as much as 25 to 30%. And this change has happened over the last couple of years. Especially if you take a brand like Fast Track, which is a youth brand, most of our spend, a lot of our spend is in the digital space, and that's the best way to connect, remain connected with the consumer, and more importantly, bring about a meaning for your brands, bring about a change in the lives of consumers, adding value to their lives, in addition to just selling our products. We have an analytics team in our company, and they, in addition to what they unearth, we sell to about, I would say, at least 15 million consumers every year, all our brands and products put together. Now, looking at the data of what consumers are doing, how they are behaving, there are lots of truths that emerge through our analytics team, in addition to consumer research that we do. And what I'd like to share with you all are six consumer truths that emerged over the last 2 to 3 years and how we have used each of these with our brands. So I'll share six case studies for each of these. The first one, of course, is about consumers saying that I engage with brands that care, and I'll share a case study on that. Consumers saying that speak to me in my language. But this is a flip story on that, and I will, when I talk about it, I'll cover that. Consumers are saying that brands need to add value to my life. The next one will be about false reality, and that's a space where, you know, everybody is on the net, everybody is uploading whatever they are doing, but there is a truth there, and there are some people who are saying that, why don't you be just real? Why are you living a second life? And this is a signal we picked up, and I'll share with you how we use that. We also know that, I wouldn't say gone are the days of celebrities and endorsements and brand ambassadors, so to say. But today, peers influence a lot on social media, and they play a very important role, as we all know, for all brands. And we need to recognize that, and I'll tell you how we've used that. And finally, of course, the universal truth that fitness is key and how consumers are changing their life every second day. Talking about the first one, so we looked at the consumers and what are their concerns, especially about women. Over the last couple of years, women's safety has emerged as a very, very important aspect, and we all know that. If you go to small towns and you look at, not villages, but even tier 2, tier 3 towns, there are cases of women and girls who are not allowed to step out in the dark because it's not safe. They are not allowed to pursue their passion in some cases, purely because it's too safe, it's not unsafe, and therefore they're not able to live their lives freely. The other big concern linked to this is the need to immediately connect with your near and dear ones the moment you are in trouble. So we recognize this, and all of us know that. And let me tell you what we did with one of our brands. We created our in-house R&D team along with an external partner, a startup. We created the first safety watch for women. This was about a year and a half back. It was called Sonata Act. The way this watch works is that there's a special button that you see at the 8 o'clock position. You press that button. We used to call it the Art Ka button. That's how people used to talk about it. You press that button whenever you are in trouble. You have to press it twice successfully, very quickly. And 10 people get alerted, whoever you've nominated. That you are in trouble, and on their phone it also shows where you are. So it shows the location, it tells you that you are in trouble. So this was one example of an app-enabled coordinates tracker that we created and developed, and it's done very well, especially in small towns and markets. Let me just show you the ad that we, and I'll also talk about the insight.
क्या खेलती हो?
एथलेटिक्स.
नेशनल सिलेक्शन के लिए जा रहे हैं. इतनी लेट, वो भी अकेले?
दुकेले।
हाँ ये भी सही है, पानी लेके आता हूँ।
घर पे टेंशन तो होती होगी ना?
ना।
नहीं
नहीं, सब साथ ही तो हैं, काका, ताऊ, बड़े भाई, सब।
कहाँ?
इसमें कोई टेंशन हुई तो ये 8 का बटन दबाना है 2 बार, चुने हुए 10 लोगों को लोकेशन के साथ डायरेक्ट मैसेज।
कमाल है।
पेश है सोनाटा की तरफ से एक्ट, ताकि आपकी नजर मंजिल पर रहे।
बहुत आगे जाएंगी लड़कियां, देखना।
Obviously, we also made because it was targeted for small towns and it was targeted for women, although it's not that women in big towns are 100% safe, but we made it very, very affordable because it was a product developed by us and we wanted it to reach out to as many women as and girls as we could. What was the impact? The impact was 62% people who saw the ad said, we really love the brand. Now, see, the moment you show care, and this is the example of what I was talking about, consumers want to connect and buy brands who care for them. So the moment you care for your consumer, they love the brand. This particular product won many, many awards, the latest being that you see in the center, which is from Economic Times, the Brand Equity Marketing Award for the brand launch of the year, because it was... What they appreciated was the whole conceiving of a concern, starting from there to conceiving the product to making it a commercial success and the entire journey. The second one I was talking about was consumers saying, speak to me in my language. Now, this has been a truth for all advertising in the past few years. It's not just about advertising. Here, like I said, I'm going to be talking the flip side of it, which is consumers speaking to us in a language that they are comfortable with. And what I'm actually referring to is voice search. It's very important for companies like us to realize that voice search is on the rise. And as per Google, 20% of the search of late, I mean, in the recent past has been voice search. And this is really applicable to, you know, the archetypes that I was talking about earlier, the late learner, the early learners, or rather, the late learners as well as the early adopters, which are from small towns, who are not able to articulate the whole query, so to say, in writing, and they prefer talking. And this is very, very, very key, and therefore, they don't want to, they want to shift from, let's say, keyword to long-tail queries, and just speak out the problem that they have or the query that they have. More comfortable with that. And like I said, very, very important for companies to realize this. So we've recently, some time back, activated voice search on titan.co.in. And within the first few months, we had 100,000 plus users with approximately 45% growth rate in adoption. It is a totally immersive experience. It's rising by the day. And this is something that we all need to recognize as we reach out to consumers. Moving on to the third example, which is consumers, you know, I was talking about the truth where consumers are saying that the brands need to add value to my life. And this is a very simple example of trying to do something very, very different. It was again done by our brand Sonata in Calcutta. And as you know, the biggest festival in Calcutta is Durga Puja, or rather Durga Pujo, as they pronounce correctly. And one of the things people love really and do over a five-day period is pandal hopping, going from one pandal to the other. So over 2,500 pandals to visit in Calcutta over a five-day period, like I said. And there are about 15 million people who are, you know, wanting to cover the best of pandals. What would brands typically do? And even we used to do some of that in the past. The brands would say that, okay, you know, I have so many consumers, this is an opportunity for me to put up a stall next to the biggest of pandals. But we approached it differently last year. We said, in this whole confusion, so to say, of consumers trying to figure out which pandal should I visit, how do I go there, what do I wear, and how do I spend time, my time the best, we said we will develop an app. And today, the solution to any problem is an app. So the app we developed was called Sonata Sharodia, or Sharodio, as it's correctly pronounced in Calcutta. And this was highly appreciated. Let me tell you how this worked. This was an app which showed the best pandals to visit. So the top 250 pandals. It gave the puja timings. It had guides on what to wear, what to eat, what to gift. And it also had a selfie contest. So consumers started engaging, and they really loved this. And it was also an opportunity for us to run a selfie contest and get them to send us those pictures and help us to gratify them with our products as gifts. So within that five-day period, we had 30,000 downloads, the app rating of 4.3, which is very good. We won an award for digital marketing on that. But most importantly, I would say, is that we created something which the consumers love. I have just one comment here, but the number of comments we received from various consumers saying this is the best thing that could have happened, I will recommend this app to everyone, and it really, you know, solves my problem, was most encouraging. Now, moving on to the fourth consumer truth that I spoke about, which is false reality, and I was talking about how consumers want to upload everything. Their smiling face, and you know, we earlier heard about consumers uploading, people uploading what they're having for breakfast, what they're having for lunch. But a signal that our brand Fast Track picked up during its research was especially amongst the youth, is that a lot of youth feel that why won't you be original? Because a lot of what you're doing is fake. And Fast Track as a brand, as you know, has always taken a stand which is very different. We've known for our very edgy advertising, very different advertising, and taking a stand which helps us connect with the consumers in a certain manner. And I'll take you through the story. And like I said, the flip side of social life is that you have more followers, you know, on social media, but very few friends. People to text, but no one to talk to, and all of that. So all this is false reality, like I said. So we took a stand saying, using four words, saying, shut the fake up. And this is about being real, being authentic, expressing your true self as opposed to, you know, putting on a facade of sorts, showing that you're happy when you actually may not be. So I'll show you the ad, and I'll also show you what we did after that.
Presenting the story of your life. Swipe right, that's right. Boy meets girl, girl meets boy, the first selfie. Hashtag, 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 nice bag. What? Share it. 3 likes, 30 likes, she likes. Food porn, food gastro, insta food, insta ready.
Eat it already.
Sweet dreams, no, sweet means more memes. Stop, stop, block, block, unfriend. Oh God. The end. Worst story ever. Let's start over. Presenting the story of your life by Fast Track. Boy meets girl.
Hey.
Girl meets boy.
Nice bag.
Cool shades.
Love the watch.
Wanna see what else I got?
For real happy endings, shut the fake up. Watches, shades, bags and more from Fast Track. Mm-hmm.
So that was just the advertising. But the other interesting thing we did using digital as a medium was created what we called a fakeshnary, which was, you know, a dictionary to capture fake words that come to mind of consumers. And there were 4,200 words that consumers came back with. Very interesting words, most of them very funny. Just two examples here. One was hasho. So, you know, this was about tagging your friends with words which are new and different and which got added to the fakeshnary that we created. So one was hasho. So this is for people who are hashtagging anything and everything, you know, in any random picture. The second was lollipop. So just picked up two from 4,200 words that we came up with, or rather consumers came up with. A lollipop was again someone, a friend of yours, who LOLs everything that and anything that he comes across. So he was called a lollipop. So on and so forth. And this is how it helped Fast Track connect with the youth of today. Now I move on to the fifth example. And this, like I said, I'm not saying the age of brand ambassadors is over, but consumers today get influenced by so-called what we call influencers in the social media space. Here I'm going to be talking about the story of a brand that you all would have definitely heard of, which is Raga. Raga is a brand we have for women. Now, Raga is a brand we realized was turning out to be a brand which women would buy only for special occasion wear. We wanted to contemporize the brand and get women to buy them for regular wear, get a younger audience to also buy into the brand, because we had many designs. But we needed a trigger to make that happen. And so this is what we did. And all these are stories, the ones that I'm sharing are over the last year, year and a half. So this is what I was talking about. When we undertook research and spoke to consumers, they were saying, women used to perceive Raga as a very ornate watch and only for occasion wear, whereas we wanted the consumers to buy this for everyday wear and buy for work and contemporize the design language. So what did we do? We tied up with Masaba. Masaba, as you know, is as opposed to the image of Raga, which in a sense, you know, the attributes of Raga brand are it's very sensual, it's very feminine. Whereas Masaba is considered to be very quirky and very different. She also stands for fashion. She's very, very active in the social media space and has a huge following. So this was coming together of both these, and we got Masaba to create a separate line. And I'll just tell you then how we marketed this product, which is more interesting.
Tick tock, tick tock.
Let's talk. Who says tradition can't be playful? Who says old can't be new? Who says beautiful can't be fierce? And who says heritage can't be cool? Who says design shouldn't defy reality? Who says black and white isn't colorful? Who says stars are born, not made? Who says culturally rooted can't be modern? Who says quirky can't be elegant? Who says bold can't be subtle? Who says flaws are mistakes? Who says in your face lacks grace? Who says you can't make time stand still? And for those who say you can't travel back in time, I have reimagined time.
So this was about creating a product for the new age consumer, so to say, but more importantly, marketing it in a very different way. So most of our spends for marketing this brand was online. Masaba herself has a very strong following online, and she promoted it in the social media space. We connected with roped in a whole lot of influencers across the country, very, very strong influencers who showed how to wear the watch on different occasions. But some of these influencers, what they did was they ran a contest on their Instagram handle, which was about inviting stories from consumers on what makes you tick that makes others talk. So it was about many, many stories. It was many stories that we received, and it was including Veer Das, who we had used. So that was what we did in terms of ensuring that we reach out to a new audience through digital medium. And again, this product got completely sold out, much beyond our expectations. Coming to my final story, which is on fitness, and this is also on Fast Track brand. This is something that all of us are experiencing and seeing around us, the importance of fitness. But youth specifically Over the last few years, we were realizing that the youth have stopped wearing watches. And this was a matter of concern for us because Fast Track is a youth brand. So most youth, if you see today, they would want to spend all the money that they have on upgrading their mobile phone. And then we realized that some of them were taking on to wearing activity bands, not wearing watches, but moving on to activity bands, a lot of them wearing Chinese, cheap Chinese brands. So we said, why do we have to be in the space of watches? Why shouldn't we, you know, because we have to connect with the youth and be different, so we are not only about watches. So this is the story of that. And like we all know, fitness is a big trend, from contests to people uploading what they are doing, how they are exercising, pushing their bodies, daily updates on walks and all of that. And we see that happening all around us. And this is the story that I was sharing with you, which is the issue, so to say, that Fast Track brand was facing of youth not wearing. So we came up with our own fitness band, so to say, which was different from what the others were offering. This was called Fast Track Reflex, and this was a huge success. You may be surprised to hear that I think last year in quarter two and quarter three, we were the number one wearables brand in India, with all the international brands that are here. And this is data that is captured, so to say, by International Data Corporation. And they do the ranking of brands across all countries all over the world. So for two quarters, based on the, you know, the response to Reflex, it would come and just fly off the shelf. So let me show you the ad and what else we did with that.
Hey, burnt enough for the day?
No, I need to burn 350 calories more.
I can help.
Introducing Fast Track Reflex with Calorie Tracker.
The biggest appreciation for the ad came from Siddharth just now when he said, good one. And I'm sure a lot of you would have also felt that. So Fast Track has always been about, being very discreet while being edgy. So it's not about, you know, stating the obvious. So she just said, I can help. And this became a all over the online space, this became such a statement. So we had 16 million, and it became, in a sense, a pop culture. But let me tell you what happened after that. So this was just the ad, and the success story of the product that I spoke about. Our creative agency had presented two ads to us as a campaign. So I showed you one of them, and we ran only this one. The second one we realized was, like I said, stating the obvious, but Fast Track is not about stating the obvious. So just see the ad and I'll tell you what we did with that. We involved our consumers. We got the youth to, in a sense, try and complete the ad because we were not able to crack the last line, which was the equivalent of I can help here. So.
So, what does it say?
Huh? Yeah, all good. I just need some more sleep.
Me too. Should.
Yeah, so she says, I just need some sleep. And the guy says, me too, and should. And then he stops. You know what the obvious line would be, should. But we didn't want to, like I said, state the obvious. So we ran a contest and got consumers or the youth to come back with the response to that. And we received some, 3,500 entries. One of them you can see here, but many of them very, very interesting, should. So should we count sheep together? Was one of them. But this really helps in engaging with the consumer, and this is another example of how you can connect and use digital as a medium to connect with consumers. And that was really, six case studies that I wanted to share across our brands. Today, in today's world, it's so important to remain connected, to sense the pulse of the consumer. And like I said, more importantly, add value, add meaning to your brands as well as their lives. You know, the Pooja app example that I spoke about, involving them with your brand. And it is not just about selling products. It's not just about, you know, we always get into this thing about, especially people in marketing who are also responsible for a brand success into what is my price positioning vis-a-vis competition and how should I, you know, move away from the standard way of marketing. And we are experiencing this every day. I hope you found these stories interesting. Like I said, there's lots happening in India, and I'm sure all of you will create a future which is so very different. India is changing so rapidly. We can see the change around us. I'd like to wish you all the very best and end with just a slide on what's going to happen in the future in India. And this is a study which came in the Times of India of just 2 days back, in the Sunday Times, which you may have seen. Last year, the usage of TV was much higher than, internet. But next year, by 2019, as you can see, is going to cross TV. So that is how the environment around us is changing. All the best, and enjoy the rest of the conference.
Thank you so much, Ravi. Give it up for Ravi, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. I also want to burn some calories. I need some help here. Can you help me?
You're asking the wrong guy.
Yadri, can I request you to please come on stage, please, and give a token of appreciation to Ravi as well. Hello, ma'am. Can I request you to come on stage? I'm asking you. Yeah, you're in demand right now. I know the phone can be quite consuming. All right, a token of appreciation for Sir as well, please. I found your campaigns, Ravi, very relatable, very naughty, very new age. So there you go. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thanks, Ravi. Thank you so much.